has been quite a while since your last album, which we all loved, by the way.
Yeah, 6 years. But I wanted to wait until the time was right before I released my next one.
I see.
You know, so I could be sure I was going to be 100% proud of and happy with it, which I am.
Well, you're obviously very happy in your personal life.
Yeah, I've been very blessed.
We both have.
And, of course, you have two lovely children now, named Belgravia and Cloud.
Yes, that's right, after where they were conceived.
Any plans for any more?
Well...
Hello, readers want to know, have you given up on that side of your life?
No. I've been very busy working on my body and helping with other friends' birthings.
But it has been, what, 6 years since your last baby?
Yes, that's right. But after the last one, which everyone loved, I just wanted to make sure the time was right before producing another.
Yeah, so we could be sure we was going to be 100% proud of and happy with it.
And, you know, maybe do something different next time, like a boy.
So don't write you off yet. Is that the message?
No. Babies are my life. I am passionately interested in maternity. I love being pregnant.
She's also totally committed to sex.
Gary has influenced me a lot in that respect.
Right. Well, that's marvellous. Thanks.
Gary, you know what babies mean to me. They are this year's must-have accessory.
You know, darling, I just don't think I'm ready for fatherhood again after Belgravia and Cloud.
Are you bored with them already?
Yeah, I am a bit, yeah.
All the more reason to have a new one, then. Look, I don't want to go on about it, Gary, but I really want to get pregnant.
Yeah, all right, darling.
We've been trying for 3 months.
You've been trying? I didn't know, did I?
All I'm asking is for a little bit more help with conceiving, that's all. Maybe we should have sex more often.
Darling, we have lots of sex. We have sex all the time. We're constantly having sex. We had sex this morning. What do you call that?
Maybe we should have even more sex.
Look, get off my case, will you? We have plenty of sex. You know, if you're frustrated, maybe you should do some more shopping. You know, go out and buy some clothes or furniture or something. You used to be a shopaholic, didn't you?
So?
So buy another shop.
With shops.
Well, buy a bar then, or a health club. You know, maybe if you spent a bit more money round here, you wouldn't always be nagging me to have sex.
Look at us, having an argument just like an ordinary couple.
We're so normal and grounded, aren't we?
It's giving me ideas.
Debs, I said no, and I mean no.
Anyway, Gary, what we were saying, our argument.
Debs, there is nothing to worry about.
But you've heard what they say about couples that appear in that magazine. Bad things start happening to them.
What, you mean the curse of hello? That's nonsense, Debs.
Is it?
Yeah. I mean, Mel B and Jimmy, that was weird, but... And Rod and Rachel, that was spooky, I'll grant you that, but... And Mick and Jerry, and Noel and Meg, and Patsy and Liam, and Patsy and Jim, and Patsy and Dan, well, Patsy and anyone, really. But, you know, just because you appear in Hello doesn't mean you're going to split up, does it? Darling, don't worry about it. The curse of Hello is a myth, a legend, an ex-wife's tale.
Old wife's tale, surely?
That's what I said, wasn't it?
No, you said ex-wife's.
Did I? Funny.
Anyway, there's worse things can happen than that.
Like what?
Caprice. She woke up on the morning of the shoot with a zit. Right there on her forehead.
But you've never had a spot, ever?
Well, no. I did have. Before I met you, when I was 13.
You never told me. Just the one, was it?
7. They didn't last long. They didn't mean anything. Oh, Gary, I love you. Oh, God, I wish I'd never told you.
No, I'm glad you did. It's just not going to be the same, is it?
Is she from one of your fan lists?
Yeah. But this is weird, Troy. I can see she's attractive. You know, everything's in the right place. I just don't seem to fancy her.
Who is she?
I don't know.
Well, haven't you read the letter?
No, Troy, I only read the letter if I fancy them. You know? Like, pretty girl, give the letter a whirl. Ugly as sin, letter in bin.
All right.
That's what's puzzling me about this one.
Dear Gary, I hope this won't come as too much of a shock, but this is to let you know you have a daughter you never knew about. My name is Kirsty, and I am your own flesh and blood. Can we meet? Oh, my God, Dad.
Bloody hell.
I know.
Jeez, Troy.
I know, Dad.
You fancied her, your sister. You said four.
Shall I ring Master Troy's therapist, sir?
No, please don't tell her about this. I didn't mean it. I didn't.
I mean, hard as it may be to believe, Troy, I was very immature in my youth with women.
Were you?
After a concert, I get a roadie to, like, pick out the best-looking girl and invite her back to my hotel for me. I wouldn't act like that now, of course.
No, of course not.
No, I've got far more confidence in my own ability now. Oh, I can pick them out like that. If I wanted to. Which I don't, obviously. I don't go all moralistic on me. This was years before I met Debs. You know, I was probably still married to your mum then.
Oh, well, that's all right then.
Anyway, this'll be nice for Debs, cos she wanted another kid. You know, she can dress her up and take her shopping and shit. She'll be pleased. I thought you'd be pleased.
No, I'm not.
But you said you wanted another kid and, like, here she is, ready grown.
One.
Well, we can rename her. You know, she'd be like the child you never had.
She is the child I never had. What does she want, Gary?
You know, she just wants to meet me.
Nobody just wants to meet you.
Excuse me. The Pope, the Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela. Not to mention that little kid in hospital. I woke up out of the coma.
That was a miracle.
No, Troy, it was actually 4,000 watts of a Fender Stratocaster in a very small wall.
Oh, yeah. Shame about his eardrums, though.
I wonder what she's going to be like. She's half me, after all, and all that makes up me. My looks, my brain, my inner spirit.
Like Troy is, you mean? Gary, how could you have been so irresponsible just for a few minutes of pleasure? Don't you ever think of the consequences, hmm? She is going to end up more famous than me!
I mean, the thing is, Troy, I'm just so naturally, spontaneously fertile. I can't help myself. Because I'm so fecund. It's like I only have to breathe on a bird and she's up the Brian Clough. Like, you're pregnant. All right, Stumpy. Even trees. Congratulations, trees. You are now expecting shrubs. I'm like a natural conduit for reproductive life force. You just point me in the right direction and... I mean, what am I doing inviting this girl into my home? I haven't thought this through.
Last minute nerves, eh, Dad?
Shit! Hello.
It's really funny. I feel like I know you already, like, really well.
Yeah. It's cos I'm on telly a lot, actually.
Oh.
Both got the same laugh. Oh, look. Why don't you come in? Please, mosey through. Ooh. Oh, sorry, birds first.
Oh. Oh, nice to meet you. That is purely platonic, right?
Can I offer you a vodka?
Actually, can I have some cork? Coca-Cola, Gary.
Oh.
It's really funny, we've got the same mouth, the same nose, the same eyebrows. When I was growing up, I always wondered if there was a connection between us.
Yeah, like we had the same cosmetic surgeon.
No, if we were related. But I only found out recently. My mum told us everything before she emigrated. It's been like the family secret. You played a concert up in Liverpool. Maybe you remember. There was this young girl who you met there anyway, and you went back to a hotel together and spent the night together, and you were both young and in love.
Young?
Love.
But afterwards, you never seen each other again. And well, she got married to her boyfriend. But 9 months later, after that night, she gave birth to a baby girl. Does this remind you of anyone?
Well, me. I know you, obviously.
Yes, me. This face looks like me because this little girl's the daughter you never knew about. She's my mum.
What?
What?
She's my mother. And then, well, she had me when she was 16.
Oh, God, But that would mean that I had sex with a grandmother,
Gary, you are missing the point. It means I have had sex with a grandfather.
When? Who is he?
You!
Me? A grandfather?
Yes! You're my granddad.
Well, let's open the champagne.
Well, I don't think I should, really, because... I'm pregnant. You're going to be a great grandfather. What do you think of that, Grandad?
Yes, what, Grandad?
Oh, get it.
You never even had the care to see to let me know I was dumped.
Oh, I'm sorry, It's like in them days I didn't have a manager to dump people for me.
I'm joking, you cheeky monkey. Hello, pet. Been a long time, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Hey, they might have dropped a bit, but they're both in working order, sugar. You must be Debs, right?
Yes. Who are all these other people?
Ah, family out in this, isn't it, Kirsty love?
Oh, my God. Oh.
Hello. Gary Bloke's ex-girlfriend here. It's Elton John. Hey, listen, I hope you don't mind me asking, but you know that song of yours, Candle in the Wind? Is it about lighting farts? Hey? Ah, he's gone. Now, pet, put these on the stove, would you? Nice fish and chip supper for our tea.
I feel like I'm on Kilroy.
Gonna give us a tour of the house, babes?
Johnson will. I think I'll just stay here.
Oh, how are you, Gramps? Do you want me to help you up the stairs?
No!
I'll let you know which room I'm in later.
I can't wake up.
But, darling, you always said you didn't notice the age difference between us.
That is before I knew you were about to be an ancestor. Gary, I am not a snob, but they are so council. Gary, there was a pound stretcher bag with them.
Where are you going with my practice amp, Johnson?
The Blue Room, sir. It's for your relatives. They've demanded a karaoke machine.
God, this can't get any worse.
You're on fourth, sir. They really are the most fearful people I've ever had to attend to, sir. And that includes when you brought Mr. Crowe back for the post-BAFTA breakfast. You're on in 15 minutes, sir. Oh,
why?
Well, the chance to win a bottle of Asti Spumante seems to be a major factor in their enthusiasm, sir.
Uncle Frank's doing keep your hat on next, and he goes right down with pants.
Oi, garçon, Johnson, love, make us a cup of tea, would you, pet? Oh, go on, love, chop, chop. I've got some autographs for you to do. For Auntie Ethel, Margie, Sheena, and Ray.
Hang on. What's this?
Oh, standard waiver, Gary, love. Just so as me and Kirsty retain the rights to the story when we sell it. Reckon we could get a nice big spread in Hello Magazine, at least. Hey, might even get sponsored by Happy Shopper.
Look, Beryl, all this publicity and stuff, I'm having second thoughts.
You mean you want to pull out?
Well, I do, yeah.
You're 33 years too late, love. Oh, hey. Now, Auntie Edie, she wants a signed photo. Oh, and Uncle Greg said to tell you. Ah! That's for your last album. It was shite.
I feel violated, Johnson. It's not fair. I mean, no one knows for sure they're my relatives, do they? I know. I'll just deny everything. I never had sex with her. She never had my baby. I wasn't even there.
They'll insist on a paternity test, sir. A sample of your DNA taken in the presence of lawyers.
bloody lawyers. What do they want, blood?
Yes.
Oh.
Or sperm.
I think I'd prefer that, actually.
Which you'd have to provide in front of witnesses, sir.
Well, I see you've made yourself at home.
Oh, yes, thanks, Debs, love. Hey, this place is a tip, isn't it? I know what you're gonna say. You just can't get the staff, can you? Hey, they're very slack, Deborah.
Look, Beryl, it's really nice to meet you, but you do realise you can't just move in here, don't you?
Says who?
Says me. This is my house. Mine and Gary's, it's ours.
So you reckon he's gonna let you keep half when you split up?
Excuse me! We are not going to split up, we're very happy!
Oh, come on, Debs. I mean, how many times has he been married before you? I know him. He's a randy little sod, him. Remember, I've been there.
Oh, could it?
Hey, listen, I look just as good as you do once. And at least my tits are the real thing.
So are mine. These are Carstairs of Harley Street. You can't get a more expensive boob job than this.
Come on, darling, please don't go. I thought we was going to have another baby.
No, I'm sorry. I'm going.
What a day, eh, Dad?
Unbelievable.
You've got to see the funny side of it, haven't you?
Wake up, sir, 5 a.m.
I've finished, Johnson. My life's falling apart. It's a curse of hello.
You're completely shit-faced, aren't you? As per usual.
You're not supposed to talk to me like that, Johnson. You're my butler.
On the contrary, I can talk to you any way I like when you're in this state.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can. And I frequently do.
I could sack you.
But you won't.
Yes, I will.
You won't remember a thing about it in the morning.
That's a very good point. Shit. Get me a piece of pen and a paper, please, and I'll make myself a note.
Now, get it yourself.
Why are you being so horrible to me?
Your guests, sir. If I wanted to cater to the vulgar demands of ill-mannered oafs, I would have taken the job with the Wessexes. Also, I do not take kindly to being addressed as garçon, posh git, or tosser. And I was not put on this earth to be a bingo caller.
You gotta get me out of this mess, Johnson.
Right, sir. I'll get to work on a plan after breakfast.
No, I mean, you gotta get me out of this mess.
I don't know what I'd do without you, you know. I love you, Johnson.
I'm afraid I'm gonna have a terrible head in the morning, sir. First of all, I'll book you secretly into your private clinic to avoid the media.
Okay.
Then I'm going to arrange for you and Kirsty to have a blood test to establish legal paternity.
I don't understand.
How could you?
Yes, how could you? Coming into our house with your tawdry allegations. I mean...
Yes. Oh, Nan Man, you said you were sure.
I am. Almost. Well, I was. He's the only person it could have been. Well, apart from... I had to do it with the roadie to get sent through to him.
A roadie?
The podgy lad.
Not Fat Bert.
I'll get their bags.
Oh, I don't know what we're gonna do.
Oh, shut up. Hello, it's Fat Bert there, please. Ah, I'm sorry, love. Was your husband buried or cremated? Ah, so there's no chance of digging him up, then?
To the wonders of modern science. Oh. Won't you join us, Johnson?
Actually, sir, I'm afraid there's something that's rather preying on my mind. If you remember, whilst we were at the clinic, I took the liberty of booking you in for your usual detox treatment, including a total blood transfusion.
It's a pioneering technique pioneered by Keith Richards, as a matter of fact, where they change all of your blood for somebody else's. It's very refreshing.
Oh, good.
Exactly, sir. So when they took the sample 20 minutes later, it wasn't, strictly speaking, your blood.
Eh?
In fact, God knows whose blood they took out of your arm.
Keith's, maybe?
Well, kind of think about it, I did feel very mellow and serene. Oh, God, but this is awful, Johnson. So, like, Kirsty and I could... Why did you wait until now to tell me?
Well, basically, sir, because this way, by the time you wake up in the morning out of your drunken stupor, you'll have forgotten all about it.
I might remember.
Remember what?
That thing you just said. No.
Just hope you've learnt your lesson, sir.
Yeah, Dad. I mean, next time you're thinking about shagging some woman that you don't even know, you better make sure you take proper precautions.
Yeah, I will, Troy. I shall have all my sperm changed first. In a clinic.